the first one of those that is key to understand, and particularly if you are 59 years of age, it's important for you to understand, and you're still employed, the next financial year from the 1st of July, if you are over 60 or currently 59, your concessional contribution limit has gone up from $25,000 to $35,000. Now, this can save the average income earner an additional $2,000 in tax if they salary sacrifice an extra $10,000 to their superannuation. So if you're currently 59, because the way that they work out the age is that if you're 59 prior to the 30th of June, in the previous financial year, then you'll be eligible for this $35,000 contribution cap. Now, the reason why they've chosen this method of determining whether you've met the criteria, this 60-year-old criteria, is that some people were contributing $35,000 in the financial year, but they hadn't turned 60 yet, and then their occasions occur where they've passed away, and then the estate ends up paying contributions tax. So they've brought the rule forward to, if you're 59 on the 30th of June of the previous financial year, you're eligible for this contribution cap. Now, key benefit, it's one of the most beneficial ways of saving tax and building your retirement savings at the same time. Now, the same thing will occur for those 50 from the 1st of July 2014. So if you're over 50 on that date, then your contributions cap is going to be $35,000 as well. So the key thing is, if you're 49 before the 30th of June 2014, then you'll have that higher $35,000 contributions cap, potentially an additional $2,000 in tax by, you know, salary sacrificing to super, for example. For everyone else, for the next couple of years, if you're less than 50 years of age, it's going to remain at that $25,000 cap. And so this cap is what we call a concessional contribution cap, and it's made up of your employer contributions, so superannuation guarantee contributions that are 9% this year, going up to 9.25% next year. It also includes your salary sacrifice contributions, and if you're eligible, it also includes personal deductible contributions as well. Now, one key message here to understand, if you're thinking about putting a lot of money into super because of the concessional tax treatment of it, then these caps could really impact you with the bring forward rule. So this $25,000 and $35,000 limit relates to the concessional cap. You can put non-concessional contributions of up to $150,000 in each financial year, or bring forward 2 years. And that $150,000 is based on six times the current cap. This $25,000 is likely to be indexed up to $30,000 on the 1st of July 2014. And then it's likely to reach $35,000 on the 1st of July 2018. So what that means for people who are wanting to put significant amounts of money into super, or do cash out recontribution strategies, or move money from one spouse to the other spouse for Centrelink reasons, is that currently on the $25,000 cap, this cap here, it's six times that, so your non-concessional cap is $150,000. Or if you bring forward 3 years, it's $450,000. On what's expected is that on the 1st of July 2014, it will go up to be indexed up to $30,000. And that means six times that is $180,000, which means you can put in up to $540,000 in that financial year because you've brought forward 2 years. But if you triggered the cap at this level, then you wouldn't be able to access that higher contribution level for another two financial years. So just be aware of that. The tip that if you utilize the bring forward three years of contributions, and you do that in the 2013-14 financial year, you might then miss out on this cap for a couple of years, this higher level cap. Really just focusing on those people who are putting significant amounts of money into super over the next couple of years.